Hi and welcome. So, you want your characters to be renamed by the player, get a number of things to buy in the shop, or generally need some kind of input field to get values from? Let's have a look at the TextMeshPro input field today. We are not going to need a lot of code, since many features are already built straight into it. This is what we are going to create: a simple input field that grabs the player's input and stores it somewhere to use at a later time. We will also have a look at how we can customize the input field to fit our game better, like with custom colors, or a limited amount of characters we can enter. So, this is my basic scene. I have a simple background and a reason to have my player enter her name. When she did, her entry will get acknowledged by a pop-up, repeating her entry back at her. Let's start at creating the input field. You'll find it under UI, Input Field, TextMeshPro. I'll resize it so it fits its purpose. That works like any other UI element. The input field component looks like a strange mashup of a button component and a TextMeshPro component combined, but it comes with quite a few features, especially geared towards it being an input field. When we look into the hierarchy, we can see the field comes with two TextMeshPro child elements as well: placeholder and text. I highly recommend keeping the placeholder one, as it makes it clear the player is supposed to enter text into this field. Depending on your visuals, that might not always be super apparent to the players. Let's style those two in a way we want our input field to look. We can just change the font asset and the size in the input field component. Now, let's start with the most important feature: grabbing the player's input. And for this, we will need a script. I call mine input field grabber. Let's give it a string we can see in the inspector and a public method called grab from input field with a string as its parameter. In it, we will just hand the given string value to our value above to see if it worked. Back in the editor, attach the script to the input field. Anywhere else is fine too, but attaching it here makes checking our progress easier. If you scroll down to the input field component, you'll see four UnityEvents: on value changed, on and edit, on select, and on deselect. Each of them gets called when the described action is performed, and as we can see, each of those hands out a string value. On value changed is being called whenever something is entered, but the important one for us is on and edit, as this will be called as soon as our player hits enter. And it doesn't matter if it's the big enter key or the enter key of your numpad. Create a new coupling here and drag and drop our recently created grabber component into this field. You can now navigate to the script in the drop-down and pick the grabbing method we wrote just a minute ago. Make sure to pick the one listed under dynamic above, or this won't work. So let us see if this works already. I start the game, enter a name and hit enter. And as soon as I did, my input is being displayed in the correct value of our grabber script. What happens when the player hits escape? Well, nothing, since we cancelled the input. Our placeholder text will be displayed again. Alright, basics done, let's have a look at the options available to us. Because honestly, I don't think there are many names out there containing numbers or special characters and more than 32 characters, are there? The first thing you might want to set up is the character limit the player can enter. You will find it right below the point size. Set it to something reasonable, because it's always a bummer if I want to enter my name into an input field providing too few characters to fit my name into. Please. Next up is the content type. If you only allow characters from the alphabet, name is what you're looking for. It does contain spaces and hyphens, though. Pin, integer, and decimal are all for numbers only. And in those cases, you need to add the specific parser to your code to get the value you're looking for. Alphanumerical and password allow for alphanumerical entries. Plus, pin and password change the visible output to stars by default. Related to this is this checkbox down here called rich text. By default, it's toggled on. This means your players will be able to enter rich text tags into this box. For example, if I write pointy brackets b pointy brackets, the entry disappears, but whatever else I write will be written in bold. Toggle it off to remove this option from the player. On Focus Select All is a quality of life feature which will make filling out forms and input fields easier. Restore on Escape sets the field back to whatever value it had been filled with before as soon as your players hit Escape. And lastly, some neat customization options are the caret and selection color. The caret is the blinking thing at the end of your input. You can customize its width and blinking rate as well. Apropos blinking. To make your input field a bit more eye-catchy, you can animate your placeholder text with just a few clicks. Navigate to the placeholder game object and open the animation window under Window, Animation, Animation. Click the central button and save your animation to wherever you can find it. I call mine Blinking Placeholder Input Field. Click on the red recording button. In your TMP component, right-click on Vertex Color, Add Key. This way, a first basic keyframe will be created with your currently selected color. Copy it with Ctrl-C. On the timeline, navigate to roughly 0.45 seconds and set your color to something a bit lighter. Jump to 1.5 seconds and hit Ctrl-V. This way, your color change will loop correctly. Once done, toggle the record button again. Your text will now blink, grabbing the attention of your player. And lastly, if you want your input workflow to be a two-step process, you can create a button and refer to the grabber script by using a new event. Add a new method to the script and call it something like handover entered value. How you want to hand it over to other parts of your game is for you to decide. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you did, please like and subscribe. It always makes my day. And did you know the input field was as straightforward like this? Anything I missed or you would like to know on top? Let me know. Have a great week.